Hello everyone, this is Rajesh Pichaimani and I am a Solutions Architect at Amazon Web Services. In this session, I am going to do a live walkthrough of a tutorial that was recently published and is authored by my colleague Vamsi Peter. This is about deploying a web app on the Nginx server and is being used by using AWS App Runner. So let's get this started. The agenda is going to be very simple, doing a live walkthrough, as I mentioned. Let's start with a quick introduction here. On this page on the right, you are seeing the QR code that will link you to the location of the tutorial that is referenced here. In the center, you are seeing a screenshot of the tutorial. It starts with an overview, what we will accomplish. And down in this, as you scroll down through these pages, you will see the different steps that I'm about to walk you and guide this process. So let's get this started. For this purpose, we are going to use IDE to execute certain steps at the beginning and then switch to the console to the remaining steps as well. I'm going to use VS Code as an example in this walkthrough. So let's get this started. I'm having two screens side by side. On the left, this is the tutorial that I was referring all along, starting with the overview, what we will accomplish at the end of the session, some prerequisites, and here is a set of implementation steps. We will go through one by one here, starting with the container image creation. I'm going to start creating a new folder here. Next. In this, I'm going to have two files that needs to be created. The first one is index.html. Contents of this will be copied from this location to the code editor. I'm going to save this file. The second file that I will have to create is the Docker file. I'm going to do a copy, paint, paste it here. I have these two files, Docker file and index.html, as per the contents outlined here. I'll do a quick verification of the Docker build from the terminal window. Looks okay. These are the few steps that needs to be completed in the VS Code. The next step is to create a container repository in ECR and push the image. For this, I'm switching to the AWS console. You can type in ECR, that will take you to the first service here, container registry. We'll start by creating a new repository, Nginx web app. We will leave all the settings as default and create the repository. Now click on this repository, view push commands. Based on the operating system where you are operating from, here are some of the steps that needs to be executed. The first one is the authentication related command. Before executing this command, I will have to type in a profile information here in the AWS CLI. We have login succeeded. The second one is the Docker build. We have seen this successful. Third one is tagging the image that was just created. In this case, it's going to be the latest tag. And last but not the least, this particular command will push the image to the repository that we have just created. Within a few seconds, we should be able to see the image in the repository. It should happen anytime. So in this repository that we have just created, Nginx web app, we have the image with the tag latest. Okay. That's the steps that was outlined in step number 2 in the tutorial. Next is in the category 3, creating an app runner service using the image in the repository. So we can say app runner. Search bar, and the first one will take you to the page just like this one. Create an app runner service. You're going to leave most of the settings as default. Here we are telling the repository type is container registry of Amazon ECR. We can browse here, get the repository name and then the tag. Because this is the only tag that we have, we are only seeing here as in the drop-down list. Select them. We will do a create new service role, app runner ECR service role. Just to stay connected with the tutorial, I'm going mapping the steps here. We are in this step, step number 5, creating an app runner service role. Choose next. Give a name, Nginx web app service. We're going to use port 80 here. Leave the rest as default and select next. This is the final review page on the full setting that we have done in step 1 and step 2 of App Runner. We have the source, the information, the deployment method. So in the step 2 of this app runner, we have the service settings, the compute information, the port numbers, etc. We have all of them left as default and finally create and deploy. We are in step number 7 here on this tutorial. So it takes a few minutes. We can also monitor the progress from the logs display here. And as it is going through this deployment, we can continue further. And we will have to wait until the status goes from in progress to running state. We can click here, the operation is in progress. Sometime in the next few minutes, we should see the status running. Once the status is running, this is a default domain where the application will be posted and accessed from. So we'll wait for that to complete. As it is going through, one thing we wanted to highlight that the cleanup is something that we strongly recommend doing after every lab in this tutorial and any future tutorials so that you are not surprised by bill at the end of this month. The way it is outlined here is Once we validate this status up and running, and we go through the content through the default domain, it's time for cleanup. And we'll be doing in the reverse direction. We started with creating the container image in a repository, and then created an app runner service. But while cleaning up, we will start from backwards. We start deleting the service in the app runner. Once it is completed, then we will go ahead and clean up the repository in the ECR console. So by this time, let's see if this is complete. As it continues further, one thing to also point out is when we access the page, what will the information look like? And that information is embedded as part of the index.html contents from here all the way to here. And this is what we will see when we access the default domain page. So let's wait for a few more minutes and it should get completed. Just want to summarize what we have done so far. The initial steps in the code in the VS tool. We created a folder. We created two files, index.html and Docker file. We did a test Docker build. Once it is done, we came back here. We created a repository. After the repository is created, we leverage this push commands based on the operating system. We apply these four set of commands in the VS Code to complete the authentication, to build the image, to apply the tag to the image, and then finally the Docker push. Once we confirm everything is fine, we use this information in creating the app runner service by pointing to the ECR repository, the image inside the ECR repository. So now it is running. I'm going to click here. We have seen the logs that have been completed successfully. And I'm going to click on this default domain and hopefully we will see this page render. Welcome to AWS App Runner, and this is information that's directly coming from this form part of the index.html. Okay. Now we have validated this service up and running. Let's complete the remaining steps as outlined in the tutorial, cleanup of the resources. So I'm going to go to App Runner console, select the service and delete. We are in the App Runner. Going to the appropriate service, choose actions, finally delete. I'll delete the furniture. In few seconds, you will see this service deleted. And the third step here is in the cleanup is going to the ECR app repository. You're already in the appropriate repository. You can also do the deletion here. It's select here, delete. This confirms the repository is successfully deleted. This is also going through and this should be completed very shortly. That's a quick walkthrough of the tutorial and hope you found the session useful. Thank you. Happy building in AWS. Thanks a lot.